request by Mr. Barry Godfrey to change the current property, which has multiple addresses, from R10 to Commercial Highway. Again, as stated in the letter of intent, he's wanting to downsize his current operation at North Valdosta Road, also known as Tillman Motors, relocate the inventory here to this property, which consists of about 1.5 acres. The property is currently considered legal non-conforming. It's been developed since the late 70s, has partially residential, also contains Handy Dan's Ice, is a commercial business venture, and two additional manufactured homes on the property as rental as well. Subject property is a community activity center and within the urban service area. However, there are no community or county utilities. You'll note the green line on your map here. Those are the city boundaries just to the east. The large square there is Georgia Military College. Further east of that, New Elementary. So you have a mix of commercial to the west, residential and institutional to the east, surrounded by residential to the south. You see an aerial here that depicts some of this. So again, this is a mixed character area as far as it goes, but it's a community activity center almost by definition. There are supplemental standards from the ULDC for vehicle sales establishment that consists of the display area for vehicles be paved, stabilized, dust-free surface, and set back a minimum 100 feet from property zone for residential use. Additionally, buffer area standards require a minimum buffer area of 30 feet between commercially zoned properties adjacent to residentially zoned properties. Health Department, again, has only two records for this particular property regarding well and septic, and again, the current property just approximately 5 buildings on it. According to public health, the lot size rule doesn't allow for any more additional use of those properties. The TRC did find the request overall consistent with the conference of plan, but the hurdles for which rezoning do consider buffering and uses allowed for future development beyond the initial request here. Again, some of your images here, you can note the house, large building to the right there, you see the two manufactured homes to the left, and the Candy Dance Ice in the middle of the property there. You know, Valdosta Electric, farther to the left, and the residences more to the right. And here's a survey of the property, a little cleaner image. There's additional storage buildings on the property. Here's a quick street view. Coming from the property, you can note the manufactured homes right behind Valdosta Electric. You can see the roof line, the Candy Dance Ice, as well as the main residential structure. If you head on from the property, the main residential structures to the left, you see the ice business and the two manufactured homes. You note that there's only about 10 feet of space between the house itself and the beginning of the commercial venture. You jump to the back porch. Of the property, the manufactured homes are on your left, back to Candy Dance Ice. And if we continue to look to the right, to the south of this picture, you'll notice again there's a bit of a buffer yard, which is also a separate parcel owned by Mr. Godfrey as well. That's some planted trees. So again, just an overall aerial to show. The property is almost split halfway between commercial and residential, but it does abut residential to the east. So buffer considerations, without being too intense for the surrounding properties, begin thinking long term how do we work with the applicant here to approve this request and put conditions on it to, again, mitigate any unsightly or unnecessary features for the residential properties to the east and south.
Commissioners?
JD, refresh my memory. You say there's a house on this property, what I call a house? And
yes, sir.
Mobile home?
Yes, sir.
And are they all rental properties?
I believe so, sir, yes.
Even the house?
Yes, sir.
And the applicant does not live there at all?
According to Q Public, the applicant's address is at a separate location.
And once again, he's planning to park vehicles there, but not sale, make any sales or run a sale for them.
But I believe he's wanting to continue the sales. They are predominantly online at this point. So there's very low traffic as far as walk-up traffic, everything's typically done online according to the applicant, taking pictures of the parking vehicles and then getting the vehicles off the property at that point. But he's wanting to use, in order to maintain his vehicle sales license, he has to have an office on property inside.
How many vehicles can he park there?
Considered standard parking size of 20 feet by 9 feet. going back to the survey here, from your lot line, 273 feet. I mean, there's quite a bit of space out there, but again, it's abutting the residential. I believe this morning I checked the website, got about 15 vehicles currently for sale. So I don't know if there would be a limit consideration for the number of vehicles to be parked on this, given that stabilized dust-free surface. The 100-foot setback from the east approximately goes just to the west side of that house, and 100 feet from the south property line gets you almost right in the middle of the middle buildings there that are handy dandy. So location consideration.
I know we had discussed maybe some conditions, such as when the mobile homes are no longer inhabitable, they cannot be replaced. We did talk about that in that work session. We also talked about limiting the number of cars, but I mean, if you can't park them there, where do they go? So,
right. And that was the consideration of any additional buffering.
Right. We did also talk about buffering to the east between his property and the property that he does not own. Those are all considerations.
I'm sorry, I'm just curious, a couple of questions. So, you know the car owner's okay with leaving the location?
I have not heard otherwise from the other park.
Is it till on the other side of the replacement site because you have to have a sign?
That would be a consideration because it would be zone commercial. Is it a signage? It could be limited to simply a wall sign on the existing building. That's a consideration for commercial zoning is the amount of signage allowed, especially in a mixed residential area like this.
So the iconic sign may not even be able to utilize. Is that what you're saying?
Correct. That's the question before us tonight, and how we're trying to, again, consider all the possible uses in a commercial highway zoning, like Commissioner Willis stated, compared to the intended use for now. Again, we understand the property is transitional, have surrounding commercial uses. It's been in existence quite a while, it's partially commercial. To get any residential impacts it might have to the east and to the south long term. And that's the consideration.
What's the alternative? Well, I guess my question is, how did we get here, number one? How did that happen, and what's our alternative?
How did we get here is a question that predates me, I'll be honest with you, again, because this property's been developed again since the 70s. It is slowly through this permitting process, and we didn't have too many permit records. I did check the permit inspection office at the Health Department, and as noted, we had very limited records for how things got to be. 2006, it kind of is what it is. I said grandfathered in as a question. It's how do we move forward now with the request with the existing property usage. Again, car sales use is not allowed in R10, and that's why it being changed to a commercial zoning. We have all three of
them. And not even as an exception. My other question was about, you said there are two septic systems.
There's two permitted uses based on the health department records. One is just a well septic for the house and then one of the mobile homes.
Okay.
So there are currently five buildings on the property.
They're utilizing two systems.
I believe it's just one system.
One system.
Which the Department of Public Health has said it's essentially maxed out based on their records.
So where's the drain, the water drain for the ice park?
Wasn't able to determine that based on the survey or the site where it actually goes.
Well, okay then.
one last question, I probably don't have answers to this. So if we change this to CH, or recommend changing it, CH highway commercial, the buildings that were there under R-10, they will be grandfathered because they were there before we made the change, or what?
Correct, they are still considered legal non-conforming uses right now, they'll continue in the CH unit. As far as any limiting on the removal manufactured home for replacement, again, commercial zoning manufactured homes or any residential is not allowed, and that's the consideration to not replace them in the event they become damaged or inhabitable in any sort of future event. But as it is right now, not necessarily in the business of the big folks.
Is there another zoning that he can do what he wants there other than highway commercial? Highway commercial just opens it up to liquor stores, et cetera,
right.
Everything.
Right.
Except manufacturing.
Yeah, that's more than put a liquor store there.
So the only other zoning, possibly a planned development PD zoning, just because of the mixture of uses on this property. Again, PD zonings do have supplemental standards as well as far as green space, community events, and at that point it becomes almost a catch-all more than a true planned development going forward. And again, you are bound by that site plan very specifically.
That's so much more appropriate than this.
Like I said, the request for CH, because it's supplemental standards for vehicle sales, is for any commercial zone, which is not allowed in residential right now. And that's where we're running into the issues of opening the door for CH compared to anything else, or strictly limiting to the existing use in the commercial lot. With a maximum number of vehicles and the condition.
What's this other number going forward?
That's what I'm trying to think. What are the repercussions of that?
Well, that new going forward, as far as,
I mean, this, as you said here, this future development, how they're going to coexist in neighborhood, residential neighborhood going forward. I mean,
it's tough to predict the future and what anybody else who might come in and buy this property with a commercial zone would want to do with it. If they would want to turn the house into a particular office for that particular handy dance ice, it's going to continue in the future if they would tear it down and then have to go through commercial plan review for anything on there. But again, there's so many unknowns here to try and think about all of them versus simply limiting it to just use one, use two.
Well, I mean, if we were to approve it as recommended to CH, we could put some conditions as far as preventing any other type of business from going in there. They would have to come back.
Correct.
You know, if a liquor store did want to go in there, at least they'd have to come back.
Correct.
So we could put some strict conditions on.
And there is precedent for that.
All the stuff going on there, how could you deny it?
It's only grandfathered in
there. I know what I'm saying, but if we're talking about putting a condition on there so a liquor store coming in, but I'd be, with all the stuff going on, there's 2 acres or whatever, I would be kind of hard to deny.
Well, there's presently no liquor store there.
That's what she said, but going forward, they can come back and get it rezoned for that.
Right. And how do we condition against all the possible unknowns?
Yeah, that's what my concern is.
Yeah, exactly. All right, well, let's open it up. We'll hear from the public. Is there anyone here tonight wishing to speak on behalf of this request? If you will come forward, please.
I'm Barry Godfrey.
Okay, Mr. Godfrey, what's your address?
2972 Moore Crossing Road Drive.
Okay. Talk to us a little bit.
Franklin, your comment was, how did we get there? I'll take you down a little memory trip road. My father had the foresight in the 60s to see that Venus Road would not remain a two-lane road, but it would go commercial. And he owned from next to where Bojangles is all the way up to the corner of Ashley Park. And they built the Shore subdivision. Franklin, we grew up there, you remember all that. Cornfield there, and those houses, they just raised cannon. And that is not going commercial. My dad said, yeah, this is going to be commercial. And so the zoning said, okay, maybe he knows something they zoned all it. Well, look what's there today.
Right.
All commercial with coexisting houses. The liquor store came on the corner and they raised cannon. Thank God it's know, now it's his personal preference, but there was a liquor store right there in the front. And all those people got along co-exhibited, okay, co-existed. So this property that my father-in-law bought in 75, I married baby daughter in 1977, I moved from Alabama back home when my son got killed in the garbage business. He operated on the corner of Oak Street and Oak Street Extension. The ice plant was in the carport. Two blocks behind it, he had the Fendville Sanitary Service, which eventually moved to here. So this place has always operated commercially. At one time, there was 365 containers maintained in Lanes County off of that property, and 10 to 12 cars up running out there every day. So it's functioned commercially basically all these years.
Mr. Berry, when that was going on, was there somebody living in the house at that point in time?
He built that home.
He did?
He
okay.
He lived there.
And running a home-based business.
Correct. There were no houses from there to Forest Street. So when I came back home to take over running that business with him, we bought all that property. We built those houses all the way down there. And I recall when the Lambs County decided to put a school down there. A school coming in there. They could. But look, we got a beautiful school down there. We got yellow buses running up down the street. Yeah, we got a little more traffic. No big deal. But come on the other side, go to the military town. We can't do this commercial. We can't close it. Yeah, we can close this. Fine. Bolton decided to put a trailer park across the trailer housing sale place across the street. So it's just the nature of, I think, Franklin mentioned, it's just the nature of the beast of how we got there is co-exhibit, co-exist. So, me presently owning with a partner, Tim Motors, been here since 1939, married with Al on Old Firehouse Road. I turned 64 in June, and I don't know how long I'm going to hang in there. But I know that at some point I won't be downsized. I don't know what that means. I think I can quit. I've always worked on it. I think I can quit for home. But I do want to downsize. And my business in the last 5 years, Tillman Motors, has changed drastically because of me. I'm a commercial truck salesman. I always sell commercial stuff. So most folks that like today, Urban County Commissioners came in today, picked up a truck, picked up Urban County siding, saying they just pick up the phone, come get it. We're doing more of that than we're doing now with people in and out. So I don't need that high-dollar exposure where I'm at now. The used car board says to maintain my license, I have to have an office, the telephone, and the sign. And you mentioned the sign a while ago. If you Google antique signs, you'll find Tibble Motor signs, yeah, from 1957 year model. It's on the antique register. People come in from all over the country to take pictures. I didn't know they did that stuff. So,
Yeah.
Now, well, when it was neon, and the sign back in the day. I know the rules. That sign I would not move there. Number one, it's not going to stay together. It could be moved. But my envision, if allowed to do that, if I chose to say, hey, this is where my office is going to be on the downside, is having a sign that meets the current qualifications that's identical to that. That unique look. You know, there, I think it would be very, very tasteful. My sister-in-law lives in the brick house, and she'll live there because she used to move it out. It's there for her parents, where she grew up. So that's going to stay. That's going to stay put. She's just the same person stays there. Trailers, I'm with you on that. Once they get your head.
Yeah.
Economics is going to say all that's going to change. Well, that's in my lifetime, that's 5 years, but that's all. That's all going to change. So I don't have any problem with that. But what my future holds, I don't know. I just want the ability, because it's already always operated as commercial, to be able to say, hey, I have an office. I've got an office sitting right there. I mean, you know, nice place. I can go hang my shingle on the wall. Put 6-8 vehicles. That's kind of what I say, 10 or 12, whatever. It's plenty of room. However, I have lots of other properties, so I'm not restricted to. If I had 20 units, I'm not restricted that they have to be at that piece of property.
Mr. Guthrie, do you have an office on site here?
Yes. Okay. Does it turn out?
The house? Or
no, it's in that front of that handy dandy.
Okay.
Put that picture up right there. That brick, yeah, that's an office.
Okay. Okay. So that is your office.
Correct. That's a cool, big nice office.
All right. So that kind of simplifies things for me a little bit. Especially since you don't have a lot of traffic in and out. And I understand, I mean, I bought a car off the internet. I know it's going to be that.
Yeah. It's a different world. Mm-hmm. Old folks, people,
just a quick question. I'm glad so you
If he only uses the front, it would have a side view.
Quote Tillman Motors.
Correct, exactly. I would come into the side view, side double, that I would come make my interest in because it's.
So I'm just curious, if a couple guys that walk around Tillman Motors during the day sometimes, are they going to be at the site here with you working internet?
My partner is 77 years old. He needs to quit. Coach Baker, Darion Baker, who cuts about off for 34 years, works for me.
He's already been quit.
He quit the day he comes to work. As far as doing, he knows everybody. He turned 70 in June, so it's kind of getting down to a neat thing. And I don't even know, to be honest with you, do I just sell out? I've got a lucrative business, and it's time for me just to shut that door. I said, well, that's that too. It'd be like you going home, you tell on me, like you can. So I only work 3 days a week even now at the office. I'm down to that. So I can see myself getting on the golf course. You can get two phone numbers on this. They can call me. They don't buy a truck. They can talk to me while I'm playing golf, and I'll set an appointment and I'll be with you. That's what I see. I don't know. The internet calls all. I don't have to be out there. I haven't had all the
time. Mr. Godfrey, I'm not trying to get into your personal business. You said your sister lives in that house now?
Sister-in-law. My wife's sister.
I'm in favor of 99% of the things you said here this evening. I just have a problem with zoning something CH commercial and not knowing what's going to happen. The trailer, I can see that. I can see the life, their lifespan. The house being sold again as a residential piece of property.
It can't be divided.
Okay.
See, we first tried to, when we settled the estate after my wife's mom and dad died, with just the two girls, we tried to divide that up so the sister could have the house. It's too close, like you said, it's tempted. There's no criteria even coming and asking y'all for a variance that would make it divide.
And even if, I mean, because if we make it CN or CH, it can't be sold as a residential property.
Yeah. And in reality, that house, when something happens to her, that house, it's going to go to what? An office of some sort. It's not going to be right there. And I talked to the neighbor next door, she called me.
I mean, is that a correct assumption? I mean, if we make this CH, that house will not be able to be sold for residential property.
Not individually, correct. You'd have to buy the whole property
right.
as a commercially zoned property.
Yeah, okay.
But the use of the house would be kind of a problem.
Yeah, the use of the house is still there. Mm-hmm. We do have commercially zoned houses.
Right.
Got it.
All right, any other questions for Mr. Godfrey? Thank you, Mr.
Chairman. Yeah, and might I add thank you for the fact that you put me to that flag and prayed in this meeting tonight.
Absolutely.
That and thank you.
Thank you, sir. All right. We've exhausted our time for those speaking on behalf. Is there anyone here tonight wishing to speak against this request? Anyone wishing to speak against? All right. If not, let's turn it back over to the commissioners. Commissioner Willis?
I still have a problem with CX. Plan to, you know, go back and look at the plan and we'll do exactly what you want and put it there.
Congratulations.
Thank you. So if you're not CX, everything is not plan buried, we'll do everything down and then you don't know what's going on. You know, where it's the repair shop or like I said, or anyone that's going across the road. But, CX is a pretty broad.
Mm-hmm.
It is. With plan development, the only way we mentioned is that problem.
Oh, yes, J.D. Irwin, he had another option. That's what you said?
Plan development is an option. It ties specifically to a site plan and some uses on there. My biggest concern with the plan development zoning is the supplemental requirements for kind of green space, things like that, 30-foot setback buffers.
And we've had a good list in the last 3 or 4 months about this plan development, coming back and trying to do something with it after the fact.
Again, I'm very leery of plan development because of that. If any change, particularly requires a full rezoning process, or even use of the flow. So
it's all
that went
across
that
mode.
All right.
Okay. So let's move on, and I'll call for a motion.
Madam Chair.
Commissioner Baker.
Case before us is in case REZ 2021-24, Mount Zion Church Road, is requesting 1.5 acres to be rezoned
ten to CA to make a motion that we do so.
All right, we have a motion to approve. Do I have a second?
Second, Madam Chair.
All right, I have a second by Commissioner Hightower. Any discussion?
About any conditions?
Well, no, the condition that he's concerned about, which is out the window anyway. It's gotta be the whole property's gotta be sold at the market.
All right, any other questions, discussion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against? All right, motion carries.